say the name of the next composer. Is that consistent with our theme tonight? Margaret Bonds. A black woman, she grew up in Chicago, and she was attuned to social activism from a very early age. Her father was a physician who founded a medical association for black doctors denied admission to the AMA, the American Medical Association. She studied music at Northwestern, but as a black woman, she was not allowed to live on campus, and she became very despondent over the racist treatment she encountered. But one day, in the basement of the Northwestern Library, she discovered the poetry of Langston Hughes, which helped build her confidence in her identity as a black woman. She moved to New York City, enrolled at Juilliard, and began a lifelong friendship with Langston Hughes, and set much of his poetry to music. In fact, when he died in 1967, Margaret Bonds again found herself despondent and moved to Los Angeles to begin again. There she continued her work for social justice and taught at the Inner City Institute and Cultural Center in LA. Interesting fact, Margaret Bonds was the first black to perform as soloist with the Chicago Symphony in a piano concerto by her former teacher, Florence Price. She died in 1972, very unexpectedly, and right after the premiere of a work given by the Los Angeles Philharmonic called Credo for chorus and orchestra. Interestingly, the Los Angeles Philharmonic tonight, I found out by coincidence, is performing the very piece that we're performing. Yeah. Gustavo Dudamel is conducting. About the piece, Montgomery Variations is a programmatic work based on the spiritual, "I Want Jesus to Walk with Me." In the words of Bonds, it centers on, quote, Southern blacks' decision no longer to accept the segregationist policies of the Jim Crow South. It is dedicated to Martin Luther King and was written in 1964 at the time of the Montgomery, Alabama bus boycotts led by Dr. King. The first movement, Decision, again in her words, quote, under the leadership of Martin Luther King Jr. and the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, blacks in Montgomery decide to fight for their rights as citizens. First movement, Decision. In the second movement, Prayer Meeting, the peaceful protesters gather to ask God to bless their efforts, and this movement is characterized by religious and evangelical fervor. The third movement, March, depicts the black citizens of Montgomery walking to work rather than taking segregated buses, and Bonds wrote, quote, the entire world symbolically with them marches. Very poetic. The seventh and final movement, it consists of seven movements. We'll just be performing four tonight, duration about 16 minutes. The seventh movement, Benediction, in my opinion, is one of her greatest inspirations in its sweeping grandeur, its hopefulness, its optimism, in spite of all that she has experienced and all that she saw around her. It seems to describe God's blessing of the entire civil rights and social justice project, of which voting rights, of course, was integral. In a country as divided as ours has been in recent years, Bonds reassures us by writing about this movement that, quote, a benign God, father and mother to all people, pours forth love to his children, the good and the bad.